crafted prayers, cleaned up the version of what I share, saying the things I'm supposed to.
To Be Loved is such a personal song for me. I grew up in an incredible Christian home. I grew up in the church. I was a missionary kid. Like, I didn't have any reason to struggle with my view of the gospel. I mean, I was hearing it all the time. But like many of us, it kind of became something I was used to. It became a list that I checked off, feeling like, okay, I will go to church and I'll do this right and I'll fix this. And so often I was basing my view of God and my relationship with God on how good I was that day and how good I felt about myself. And so then, as is going to happen, anytime I failed or I made a mistake, I would hear the enemy shame me so much and I would distort it and believe it was the Lord and think, well, okay, if my mom and dad or humans, if they get angry and disappointed when I fail them, God must be the same way. So, oh no, I messed up. How do I earn him back? I mean, I used to be so stressed by this that I thought if I had sinned at all or if I had forgotten a sin in my life, he couldn't hear my prayers. Like, it was this crazy, crazy distorted view of who God and who Jesus is. And To Be Loved for me is such an incredible song because it comes full circle with my journey of becoming a Christian at a young age, getting caught up in just checking the box, and then honestly relearning the gospel in my 20s and going, wait a second, it's enough just to be loved. Like, I don't have to do anything more. And if I'm feeling like God is distant, he's never turned away and he never will. You know, I remember I was really struggling with this and was just feeling like a failure when I was younger. And I went fishing with my oldest brother and we sat down and he said, Lydia, I understand how you're feeling, but let me pose a question to you. I said, okay. He said, tell me if this statement is true. I am worthless without Jesus. And I said, well, yeah, because it is. Yes, I'm worthless without Jesus. And he said, okay, but tell me if this statement is true. I am worthy because of Jesus. And I said, well, of course. And he said, okay, it's time for you to shift your focus from the I am worthless without Jesus to I am worthy because of Jesus. Because as soon as we accept the gospel, that is our reality. There is nothing we could do or not do to ever lose his love. And so my hope as people listen to this song is that whatever you may be going through, whatever lie the enemy wants to put in your head, that you realize there is a very simple truth in the Bible. It says, the truth will set you free. So if the gospel is the truth and you're feeling a burden, that's not the gospel. The truth is gonna set you free. That's the enemy. The Lord, he tells you you are loved. He tells you you are worthy. He tells you because of what he did on the cross, you are enough. And so, man, I found so much freedom when this message really came home in my heart. And I hope as you listen to this song, you do too.